Hello everybody and welcome back to Hers Hill and to our occasional series, as they used to say on the BBC, for gourmet tricks and treats. And the last one we did was such a success that you'll see I've invested in a branded pinny, which I hope you all like. And today we're going to be a little bit retro. So what's the first thing that pops into your head when I say stuffed tomatoes? No, not that, Julie. No, let's behave. Stuffed tomatoes, what does that mean to you? Well, to me, it reminds me of when I first came to London when I was a student. Late 60s, early 70s, so you can do the calculation. And that was the beginning of a great boom in bistros. So to me, it represents blue gingham tablecloth. And the height of chic, if you remember the height of chic, was a bottle of Chianti in a basket with a candle in the top. And the worst thing you could do to your hostess was to take off the candle drippings. However, enough of that. But today we are going to look at stuffed tomatoes. If you're going to be a bit gourmet, you'd have to say tomato farci. And I had to have a bit of coaching to get that sort of right. But anyway, here we go. First of all, you need tomatoes. And you need them with the on the vine, with the stalks still in there. And choose the right size. I'm just going to do two today. We prepare the tomatoes first of all by just slicing off the top. And I slice a tiny amount off the bottom just to make sure they're going to stand up straight. And then scoop out the middle. The middle doesn't get wasted. We're going to use it again in the filling. But take the middle out. Make sure you don't pierce the bottom. Put that in there. We'll do two of them. And a little bit off the bottom. When I say this is retro, you know, my food hero is Simon Hopkinson. And some of you, I'm sure a lot of you know who he is. And the best book on retro food is one that you can't really get very easily, but it's of course called The Prawn Cocktail Years. And in it are fantastically retrospective dishes, but the proper methodology and ingredients, so it's really, really good and worth doing. But as I said, you can hardly find it, and if you do, it might cost you 40 or 50 quid, but if you can pick one up anywhere, do take it. Now I've taken the centres out of these. They don't get wasted because they go into the onion mix, which I'm going to add to this. So in that bowl, I have sausage meat, some parsley, and some thyme. And I'm going to add into that now grated lemon zest and my onion mix. Now this is shallots, garlic, slowly fried, not browned, and then mixed with that tomato paste, tomato filling, to make a sort of a jam-like consistency. So we want to make all that gel together. Very simple to do if you've got the ingredients sorted out. And this is our stuffing. Do you remember in the old days, we used to stuff these things with rather insipid, tasteless rice? We don't want to do that anymore. So this is very, very tasty. I add my secret ingredient, which I always cook with pork whenever I can. And this is fennel seed, which I've pounded in a pestle and mortar down to a kind of fine consistency. It makes a really unusual flavour and just makes it pop out a bit. So season the inside of these tomatoes and then fill them with the paste. Not overfill them, don't put too much in because you're going to sit the top of the tomato back on itself. So we'll do that. That's a little bit too much, but squash it in. Put that back on top. And then you take a Keith Floyd measure of dry white wine, and you just pour it into there. Cover that with tin foil, seal it like that, and that's the preparation. That now goes in an oven at 170 fan, as Mary Berry would say, and you leave it in there for half an hour. But after 20 minutes, take the foil off, whack up the temperature by another 10 degrees or so, and leave it for half an hour. So we'll put that in the oven now, and you'll come back, and I'll see you in 30 minutes. So here we are, and I have to confess, took a little longer than 30 minutes, so you'll have to use your own judgment. Let me just shut the oven door. So looking good, and I'm just going to serve these on these rather fine china bowls. And there's an interesting alchemy happens to the juice, because it takes on a very, very rich tomato-y essence. And I would just have this with some Melba toast, or some sourdough toast, and there you are. There we have it. Hope you enjoy it, and we'll see you next time.